No.
He came daffy in around there, so too. You know the outside of the passage.
Yeah, man,
I run me for running, you know.
Oh.
I run, and Jaffy and Fresh come through the gate with two more, man. Jesus.
Welcome back to My View TV, the people's platform, the home of undiluted news, reviews, updates, and your daily dose of entertainment. Don't forget to hit the notification bell. Leave us a comment, like, share, and subscribe.
I don't bring nobody forward in your future for me. Everything where you see up my natural talent. Let me tell you something. You see, when you know what to please the audience with, it's simple, me.
Wagwan people, open body in okay, open body in alright. Let's start this evening by sending our prayers and spreading some love to all. I asked Almighty to grant you the most beautiful and blessed evening. That is all I asked the Almighty to do. Hold on now, people. One holy passing thing still are going on in the news. You understand? Pull the aside and I get for God's school. I know now wonder what happened to him, so I can start the news right this up. A teenage boy died following a collision on Thursday with an ambulance in Mountain View Avenue in St. Andrew. He has been identified as 16-year-old Asada McCarthy of McIntosh Drive, Kingston 3. The police report that about 3:30 a.m. McCarthy was driving. That is what I said, people, but it wasn't a car. One motorcycle along Mountain View Avenue towards Vineyard Town. On reaching the vicinity of Tremaine Road, the motorcycle reportedly crashed into an ambulance as it was negotiating a turn onto Tremaine Road. McCarthy sustained several injuries and was assisted to the hospital by the same ambulance. You understand how him look up in where he died while undergoing treatment. Half a tree police are investigating. Anyway, people, make I move on. Still don't have a big old dirty Clarendon. Yes, right down there, still there. Here, one now. A Clarendon man accused of the fraud order out of US 9000 was remanded when he appeared in the St. Catherine Parish Court yesterday. David Harvey, age 35, who was charged with larceny by a trick, was ordered to return to court on August 3rd. At that time, an application for bail is expected to be made for the Maypen laborer. Yes, people will tell them like no laborer at all, you know, and all them supposed to get slapped with. In court yesterday, his attorney, Nicole Ferguson, argued that his client is a fit and proper candidate for bail as he has a steady place of abode and he has no previous conviction. But his lawyer was told by a parish judge that the court needed more information on Henry before bail could be considered. The judge noted that the police had indicated that Henry was previously charged with similar offenses. He was then remanded until August 3rd. Allegations are that on August 18th of 2022, the accused collected money from the complainant in a business transaction. The complainant reportedly had a disagreement with Henry and demanded that the money be returned. He was then given back what was believed to be the full sum, but which turned out to be US 180 in single note. But Jesus, US $180 in single note. But all I complain that a full photo. All this I complain that they are big and stupid. Anyway, people, the police were contacted and following an investigation, Harvey was charged with larceny by trick. This will get trick. Big and fourfold. Anyway, I can't move on to the news. Police meet with stakeholder in Westmoreland amidst crime wave. Amidst the obstruction murder shooting in Westmoreland, commander of Westmoreland Division Superintendent Wayne Joseph met with hotel operators and other stakeholders to discuss the crisis. Westmoreland has recorded more than 100 homicides since January, the second highest in the country, just behind St. James. Several murders have been committed in the parish over the last 2 weeks. Yes, people. One only for people are dead down in Westmoreland. People just are dead, sir. Yes, people just are dead left, right, and center. But because of the police, they do about it. We tell them about fight crime, but them not listen to it. All of the need for do is slap with hands of the old dirty criminal them and their family. Every one of them got to go. Remember this man me telling us a papa dead? I can give an update now, people. Police identified the man shot dead in Westmoreland operation. Firearm seized. Yes, a papa them attack. No me as the birth cert. You can give the people them the exact information. All the thing me not gonna give you no. I tell you no which police kill him. You understand? Me know, but me not tell you no. The Westmoreland police are reported that a firearm was seized from a man who was fatally shot during an early morning operation in Vietnam District, Westmoreland on Friday. Our news team understand the operation was carried out by the police personnel from SeaTuck. Yes, people. And them guy road gangle the bangle, you understand them, have to say? The deceased man has been identified as 20-year-old Anthony Fraser, otherwise called Grandspan or Papa. I mean, can't tell the people them something. Him dead like dog. Dead. You understand? Reported that while conducting operation at the residence occupied by Fraser, members of SeaTuck team had to force open the door to the three apartment boardhouse after the occupant failed to open the door. It's reported that while the cops finally breached the residence, Fraser pointed a firearm in the direction of one of the lawmen. The officer took evasive action and discharged 6 rounds. Bap. I wonder if me miss gone. But a 6 no. You understand? From his Glock pistol. Fraser collapsed, reportedly clutching the firearm in his right hand. The weapon, a 45 pistol with a magazine containing 6 rounds, was seized. The police said Fraser suffered from gunshot wound to the chest, was transported to the hospital. Dead. Yes, man, me tell you no. Once you don't feel like you want in a confrontation the police, you're not gonna get slapped, boy. You understand? Remember the commissioner come out and tell you already. Once my lawman and Unabaka road, my lawman got to win. You understand? And the police them win this one here. But hold on the now, people. Right out of Bulbe, I'm gone. Whole heap of ball in me here. You understand? But me ever see what the people them are going about the ball in, because the people them know the criminal elements them. Ooh. Deal with this operation, you understand? All of them supposed to get slapped away. And if you know them, mama and them papa too, them supposed to get slapped away too. Said what I said, and I mean what I said. And me not take you back. You are going now, people.
Jesus.
Relax, brother.
Jesus!
No.
He killed Jaffin around there, so too. In the outside of the passage.
Yeah, man,
I run, me for running, you know?
Oh.
I run, and Jaffy and first come through the gate with 2 more, oh, man. Jesus.
I'm tell you about that.
Jaja.
Jaja. Mama Claude. No, sir. Oi. Nasty, I'm sorry. You put them out. You put them. You put them nervous.
Today. That money, come.
Jesus!
No!
He killed that thing around there, so too. In the outside of the passage.
Yeah, man,
I run me for running, you know?
Oh.
I run, and Jaffy and first come through the gate with 2 more, man.
Jesus.
People from the ear of the audio, you know, send me at the video. So all you need for do, looking at the description section, click on one of the link, find yourself in one of the group, and you will see it. You understand? And make I tell you something. Make sure I say you're too much chunk. You understand? Because, hold on, that is a surprise. Because I tell you, make sure you say you're too much chunk and forward and come look. Anyway, now, my God of Uncle Sam country, because when Jamaica can over there, in get trouble. You understand? The man take one stone and beat one man to sickness. Let me tell you what one power one for that now. Jamaican accused of beating man with rock at US hotel. A 19-year-old Jamaican man has been denied bail after allegedly using a rock, which is a big stone, people, to severely injure a man during a fight at an hotel in Pennsylvania, United States. The boy named Kimari Reid, and people, he's a little ball tail. You understand? He made plot about him on a rasta. He's a ball tail. See him picture there, yeah man, that the boy there want ball tail. Make I tell you something about Uncle Sam country. Only keep him. We don't want him back at Jamaica none tall. Keep him up there, you understand? Fix him business up there too. Send him back in our box. We will take him back at Jamaica in our box. That is what I say. So what I said, then I mean what I said. I know me already. Me not take him back. Me go and drink some of my soup. I soon come back, come go to our next review.